students, we really start with just the basics and we have to build them all the way up. And so Greg and I wrote that thing to just look, this is basic Bible content. We just need to talk about the Bible here.
Yeah.
And then we can build yourself up.
You know, on that point, I mean, this is germane to our conversation today. I'll introduce the book, then I'll get back to the point I was going to make. We're talking today about Handbook on the Gospels, which is written by our guest, and it's a handbook on Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. This is published by Baker Academic, and it comes in an entire series that Dr. Glad has edited, which is a companion, in a sense, to the Baker handbooks on the Old Testament. We'll get to that in a second, but I was talking with a friend of mine who's a longtime minister in the OPC, has a lot of involvement at the General Assembly and whatnot, and on the committees. And he has done several ministry readiness seminars, is what we call them, where we'll often talk to guys that are kind of they've been in seminary for a year or two and then kind of maybe going to go on to an internship or a pastoral call. And he was amazed to find out, you know, he'd even encountered a student or two that were in seminary that had not even read the entire Bible in their life. And I remember in my time at Westminster, we had an English Bible exam, which was a requirement to, you had to pass it with an 80% in order to graduate with an MDiv. Just pretty common stuff. It wasn't anything too complicated, but there were always people that would complain about the exam because they said it was too trivia or minutia. And now maybe you don't want to be asking, like, well, who was the third, you know, what's the order of all the sons of Jacob, but you know, maybe there's value in knowing that, but I mean, if you don't know the precise order, are you going to be a failure in the ministry? Okay. Now we get the difference there, but I agree with you entirely, Ben, that there seems to be just a much more of illiteracy that's spreading throughout the church. And we can become so fascinated with biblical theology and systematic theology and looking at the doctrinal concerns, even sometimes getting into the details of particular interpretations of particular texts. We might not even, you know, be able to say, you know, just John 17, what's in there? And somebody might not know exactly.
Right. That's exactly right. You know, I think so. It's easy to confuse Bible content with just Bible facts. So my brain does not do well with facts. The order of the kings, the order of Jacob's sons. I mean, I struggle with some of those, pieces, or maybe some of the dates, or my brain doesn't really like historical bits like that. I'm not really talking about historical facts per se. I'm talking about, not that you can dismiss those, but I'm talking just about general Bible content.
Yeah,
what is the book of Galatians about? Romans? These major threads, these major books that students really struggle with. They really struggle with articulating, just grasping those ideas. I was, so Julius Kim is here this week. He's the director of TGC, and he's giving a lecture series here at RTS. And just yesterday, this is amazing, he said that he went to the women's TGC conference and then the regular TGC conference, which is mostly men. And he noticed such a huge difference between the women and the men that he said that the women are hungrier. This is amazing. Hungrier for the Bible.
Sure, I believe it.
And I think it's because pastors today, they're so into understanding culture, working with culture, theological nuance, this debate, that debate, that really it's the Bible content is just kind of like, I hate to put it, just kind of, it's marginalized. That because I think a lot of preaching just isn't about the Bible anymore. It's about other things.
It is totally.
And so, you know, like, do you see the irony here?
Yeah.
I mean, come on. I you know, I wonder if there are other denominations. I'm thinking about the SBC now, where there is a whole stream within the SBC of just faithful Bible expositors that are just, they get up and they just preach the Bible. And I'm like, man, that is great. I, in some sense, the PCA is kind of getting away from that.
Yeah.
So I'm unsure about the OPC, but I just feel that that we're so into historical theology and systematics that we've actually started to ironically minimize, not consciously, not willing, you know, but it's happening.